I've seen this morning. I had a buck come through before it got daylight. Come here from right out of the field. I walked that logging road, went back up in there. And I don't know, what, 20 minutes after it got good, and, well, it wasn't really good in daylight, but it was daylight enough. I had a doe, or two does come in here. They come out that logging road, walked straight down in there to my salt. Made a little bit of the salt, they walked out in the field. Let me get this bow on them. But they come in there, that salt, ate a little bit, and they went out in the field. I think I got a little bit of footage of them, but not much. And I was sitting here watching two squirrels over here mess around and fight each other. I looked up and I seen a doe coming straight at me. Where she went, I don't know, because I was sitting there watching her. I lost her. She went behind a tree. And I had to look down. There was a mature doe standing underneath the stand. And I had a little yearling run up in there. Well, to my right here, it was like a Cinco over here. They went around that Cinco and won't come right up through here to me. I don't know where the mother two deer went. I say that's the one doe came in here by itself. I know she didn't go, I don't know, 45 yards. She's down right over there, so I'll give her about 20, 25 minutes. Down, take all my stuff to the truck. We'll go retrieve that deer. Great morning.
What you like to see a complete pass through. That rage opened her up, I'd say. Blood all over it. Let's go get her. There she is. She was quartered away from me, and I put it right in there. She'd come out right the other shoulder, I'd say, but good mature doe. Had a great morning this morning. Got in the tree early, and I had a buck come in. It was still dark. I mean, I could see the deer. I couldn't actually shot the deer, but it's a good sized buck. He come out of the beans. There's a little logging road over here. He come out my right, or straight into that logging road, and walked up on a neighboring property. It wasn't 20 minutes after that. Had enough camera light. Had two does come in on me. When they come in, they didn't want none of the salt. Man, she went straight to the beans. So they went out across the field, and I'm sitting there. I look up. See another doe coming down through here, coming directly head on to me. Well, I get the camera on her and I turn to reach for my bow and I lost her. Well, I'm sitting there looking for her and I hear something to my right and I look over. This mature doe was standing almost underneath my stand. She comes in, had a little one with her. Comes in, starts eating that salt a little bit, goes straight to the beans. So I'm sitting there doing my interview, you know, saying I had two deer come in on me. Well, I look up, but here she comes walking back in. Or it might not be them, but I think they were still out in the beans. This might have been the doe I couldn't see coming straight down and hit on to me. She might have cut off down through here and circled around to me, but regardless, I made a good shot on her. She run, I don't know, 40, 45 yards, fell over. I'm tickled to death. I wasn't going to shoot no does, but passed up a few last weekend, opening weekend, and I thought, well, I spent all this gas money to come all the way down here to Hart County. I'm going to put some bike straps in the freezer. So. Well, I ain't going to waste much time. I'm going to get her out there, get her field dressed, get her home, get her in the freezer. Great morning. Sticking her with me.